grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Thank you. It's wonderful to be here with you this evening. As we gather to celebrate the mystery of our participation in the divine life we are offered through within in Jesus Christ, we gather here with great joy to say thank you for the many gifts that we have received through the grace of God. In a special way, whenever we have the honor of celebrating a baptism, we call to mind our own baptismal promise that being baptized we made part of the body of Christ and part of his life. As we prepare to celebrate the divine mysteries this evening, we call to mind our continuing need for God and for his love and mercy in the life that we shared together. Lord Jesus, bread of life, Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, sower of the seed, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, fruitful word of God, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
When the sun rose, it was scorched and withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit 100 or 60 or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The disciples approached him and said, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" He said in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven has been granted to you, but to them it has not. To anyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away from him. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see, they hear but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'You shall indeed hear but not understand, you shall indeed look but never see.' Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly listen with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their hearts and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Hear then the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it, and the evil one comes and steals away what was sown in his heart. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy, but he has no root and it lasts only for a short time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he falls away immediately. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety or the lure of riches choke the word and it bears no fruit. The seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100 or 60 or 30-fold. The gospel.
Speaking
Isaiah speaks almost exactly the same words. Some people would say how terrible it is that we still have the same problems. And other people would say how terrible it is that the same problems came back. We have to realize that human beings have not changed that much. Our hearts are hard. We don't listen. When we do listen, sometimes we say, oh, well, that person is saying that. After all, they don't know what they're talking about. We don't listen to anything. And now it's even more difficult because we're told that once we spend a little bit of time on the internet, it starts knowing what we're looking for, and it suggests that we already agree with only. We walk around wondering why no one listens to one another anymore. We're being programmed, but the programming came already from our nature. God himself comes to earth and he puts a plow on it and says, I want you to have more than what you have. I want you not to have your life, but my life. I don't want some, a piece here and there, sometime now and again, 1 hour a week. I want it all. I want it all. Remember the old saying, some people are terrified to give their fingers to God because after all, he might take my whole arm too. That's right. But that's what he's after, so that you can have a divine life. You've heard this from me probably more than once or twice or three times even. Human beings become divine beings in exactly the same kind of way that caterpillars become butterflies. It's in our nature to live a divine life. Jesus Christ reveals it to us, gives us baptism, incorporates us into our body. And we rather desire to be by ourselves. By ourselves. Many of us, and I'm right there with you, are waiting for an end of this mask-wearing time and problems and so on and so forth. And I would suggest to you, I'm right there too, but if we think for a moment that all the problems in the world are going to go away when this is over, think again. Because the worst things that have happened in the time that we've had this upon us were already ready to crack before it happened. They were already there. Vaccine will not cure those things. It will not prevent that virus from spreading. That one, only Jesus Christ can prevent. The opening prayer today says, may we who bear the name Christian strive towards whatever does it honor. May that be on your mind and in your heart every moment of your life from this moment forward, if it wasn't already. May it be right there. When you don't honor it, you go, oh, whoops. Take a deep breath, say a prayer, move on. And understand every day that we work to allow God to do his work in us by giving him a place for his word, for the seed of his life to flower and bloom, so that people don't go, look at that neurotic bunch always fighting with each other. But they go, look at their life, look at the peace, look at their joy, and they want to be here with you. That is our mission. Go and to make apostles and disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That's our mission. How often we fail. We think of only what we got right here, right now. Give us a vaccine. Meanwhile, the inside of me rotting away. The vaccine saves my life, but to return to me being a non-living, hard-hearted thing, then what good is it? The remedy has been given to us, and it's free. And it's you. So today, let's start do this here and now, so that when people look at us, see us, they want what we have. That is Christ. He's already asleep. All right, we're going to do a little baptism here for Maria Ida. Amen. What do you think? Want to go to the font now, Maria?
Mr. Builder, you're the can see if you're coming to Mass or not.
Although we're in this day. All right, you're better than anything. Please stand. Trusting in God's loving mercy, we offer now to Him our prayers and petitions.
Our response to these petitions is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that every believer would be fertile soil for the growth of God's word, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those called to government service, that they strive to lead ways of peace and justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For military members and all those in service professions, that God will give them strength and help them be instruments of healing and compassion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our benefactors, as they selflessly and generously give to the missions of our diocese, parish and school, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from physical and spiritual hunger, that they be filled with healing goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all with COVID-19 or any other illness or disease, and for those that are suffering from addiction, that God's healing love will relieve their pain, strengthen their minds and bodies, and restore them to full health, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have requested our prayers, and for those who have no one to pray for them, for the silent intentions we hold in our hearts, and for all who have died, especially for Mr. and Mrs. Morris Williams and daughter Pat, for whom this Mass is being.
Every good thing. Grant what we ask in the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look upon the offerings of your church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just to give you thanks and praise you, a hymn of glory and praise, O Lord, Father of infinite goodness. For by the word of your Son's gospel, you have brought together one church from every people, tongue, and nation. And having filled her with life and power of your Spirit, you never cease through her to gather the whole human race into one. Manifesting the covenant of your love, she dispenses without ceasing the blessed hope of your kingdom and shines bright as a sign of your faithfulness, which in Christ Jesus our Lord you promised would last for eternity. And so with all the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and with all the church as one voice we acclaim.
Thank you.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the wedding supper of the Lamb. Lord, amen.